First up, small and mid-cap shares have long been the happy hunting ground of investors looking to generate outperformance. But in the South African market, at least, sentiment towards this sector fluctuates in line with the broader market cycle and often in a pronounced way. The Cogito Alpha Fund specializes in exploiting the opportunities in the smaller cap space sector. Cogito Capital Director Anthony Durham joins us in studio to share his views. Welcome, Anthony.
Hello, Erica.
So I hope we got the technical aspects of that right. So you've got a hedge fund with various hedging strategies focusing specifically on the small cap space. So my starting question is, and Warren and I discussed this, we know in the small cap space liquidity is limited. My understanding always is that to be able to implement hedging strategies, you need liquidity.
Well, certainly we do take some basis risk in our hedging strategy. So we basically go long small and mid-cap shares, and what we do is we short the market against those. So we take a very simple vanilla hedging structure on the index, and we take some geared positions, limited amount of gearing in our small cap exposure.
Anthony, do you specifically try and hedge the small and mid-cap indices, or do you use the broader market, the top 40 or the all share to do that?
Yeah, I typically do it on the J200, which is the top 40 index.
And the point we made in the introduction there about these often pronounced movements in the small cap, medium cap space. Often if there's a bull market, you see a run in the small caps and various private placements. Everyone's keen on the sector. When things are tough, there's a withdrawal from the sector. Is that true, and does that create opportunities?
No, absolutely. The inherent weakness in the strategy is that when there's a flight to safety, you could see a divergence. You know, small caps will underperform large caps as people flock together into the larger, more liquid counters. As that kind of reverses and unwinds, you will then outperform. So we think as the world, systemic risk around the world dissipates, the abundance of liquidity will take out volatility in the markets, people will feel more confident, and you'll see the kind of the unwind out of defensives into kind of growth counters again.
Anthony, we've seen, and it seems very sentiment-driven in our local market around the small and mid-cap space, because as we say in the bull market, there seems to be that appetite, and then it evaporates for a couple of years, and then it starts coming back. I mean, just in terms of that, where do you think we are at the moment with regards to attitudes to the sector?
Well, for the last 3.5 years, there's been absolutely no interest in small cap shares. We were knocking on doors of companies that hadn't seen any market participants for literally since the crisis. So that presented a wonderful opportunity for us. We were able to build, stakes in companies, over time. It takes time to build up stakes in illiquid companies without any competition. So we were able to have a great first move advantage because just nobody was looking at these companies. Spain was about to default, and then Italy, then Greece, then Cyprus. As the systemic risk has dissipated, a lot more money has flowed into these counters, and they're starting to, they've re-rated dramatically over the last 8 months.
So you refer to these counters that you were looking at. So where have you been accumulating? What stocks?
Well, we've got some conviction bets in about 5 or 6 companies. We can talk through them. But basically, the biggest holding in the company is Sepaku, is one of the biggest, not the biggest, which is basically a cement startup company. It's going to start producing about 2.5 million tons of cement per annum in November this year, at a materially lower cost advantage to its competitors. We think that there was a real value margin of safety underpinned with the price we bought it. We thought that the risks were quite low, and the potential upside was great. We think that it could well do a rands in earnings in its first 12 months of production. We bought it at 3 rand a share. So on a forward 18 months out of 3 times earnings, we thought the risk relative to the potential return was really in your favor. And this is what you can do. The small cap sector is so inefficient, so mispriced often, that you can find these fantastic opportunities.
I think that share, if I'm not mistaken, has almost doubled in the last 6 months. And I'd like to ask you, is it still attractive at these levels?
I think possibly in the short term, it's fully priced. The share has run hard. There's still some execution risk in terms of getting the plant up and running. The big question mark is whether they'll be able to sell